Hi children, welcome you all for the today's English class.
Children, today this is our
day 8 session of
reading and writing. So make use of this opportunity, children. So please follow the instruction. Write the lines as it is we are following, because Principal Ma'am instructed clearly that only 6 lines need to be written every day on our sessions. So while we are sending the teaching videos, along with that we will send the handwriting video also. Please follow, read and send your videos Ruby's English group, and write and send it to your handwriting book photocopies through Teachmint. Please follow the instruction, children, and do as it is, children. Let's move on to the session now. Children, let's start the reading part. Your textbook Honeydew, chapter 1. The title of the chapter, The Best Christmas Present in the World.
Children, let's see today's reading part from page number 16 from our Honeydew book. First prose, The Best Christmas Present in the World. Look at the first line, children. She said nothing, but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. She said nothing, but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. Her eyes were filled with tears. You told me you did come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. You told me you'd. It is not you did, it is you'd. You told me you'd come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. I'll repeat, children, the first two paragraphs again. She said nothing, but stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. You told me you'd come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. I sat down beside her. Look at the third paragraph here, children, the last paragraph of this prose one. In the next session, we will see the next poem, that is The Ant and the Cricket. Look at the third paragraph here. I sat down beside her. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. If it always made me feel you were with me. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you're back. You can read it to me yourself. Would you do that for me, Jim dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I'd love that so much. And then perhaps we'll have some tea. I've made a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. So that's the last paragraph and the climax of the story. So see here, children, I'll repeat that paragraph again. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you are back. You can read it for me yourself. Would you do for me, Jim dear? I just wanted to hear your voice again. I'd love that so much. And then perhaps I'll make some tea. I've made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. Michael Morpago. So that's the name of the author, children, Michael Morpago. So I'll repeat the three paragraphs again. Keep your fingers and read, listen to me and read along with me, children. Pronounce the words properly. In this paragraphs, we have so many contractions, short forms of the words. So listen carefully and pronounce the words properly. She said nothing, but she stroked the letter tenderly with her fingertips. Suddenly, she reached out and took my hand. Her eyes were filled with tears. You told you'd come home by Christmas, dearest, she said. And here you are, the best Christmas present in the world. Come closer, Jim dear, sit down. I sat down beside her and she kissed my cheek. I read your letter so often, Jim, every day. I wanted to hear your voice in my head. It always made me feel you were with me. And now you are. Now you're back. You can read it to me yourself. Would you do that for me, Jim dear? I just want to hear your voice again. I'd love that so much. And then perhaps I'll have some tea. I've made you a nice Christmas cake, marzipan all around. I know how much you love marzipan. Michael Morpago. So that's the today's reading part, children. Only three paragraphs from the last passage of the first prose, The Best Christmas in the World, written by Michael Morpago. So that's all from the today's reading part, children. Now let's move on to the writing part of today. Children, take your handwriting book and follow the instruction. Write the date first, children. Then draw lines and please follow the page, maintain the page. Please don't write extra lines. Only when we have a English teaching video, we have write handwriting session. In that session, how many lines I'm writing, the same line should be written in your handwriting book. So this will be checked by ma'am when you submit your handwriting book. So please write along with me and don't write the extra pages and don't write ugly. It should be neat with proper pattern. So as it is given the dotted lines, your handwriting should be maintained. So please cooperate with us and do the needful. Let's move on to the today's writing part. Children, let's start today's writing part. Take your handwriting book, all of you. Page number 5. Date, write the date first, 26/8/2021. Today we are going to write letter M and letter R. So, first write the date, draw lines, then start with the dotted line. First, let me start with the dotted line first. Follow me, all of you children. Write over the dotted line, sharp your pencil and then write. Sharp it first. Write slowly like this over the dotted line, children. So follow the stroke and maintain the handwriting book neatly, children. Most of you not drawing lines, please draw lines and write neatly. Follow the instruction and write neatly. So write over the dotted line first. So see here, write over the dotted line first, then you can start write the next lines. Don't forget, first you need to start with the dotted line, children. Children, let's start the next line. So first we have completed the dotted line. Next line we are going to write. So follow the same pattern as it is. Should be very slanting. Follow the same cursive pattern as it is, children. Follow it as it is. Start from the curve. Start from the curve like this. Follow the format as it is, children. So I have completed the dotted line and the next line. Remaining line you need to write from page number 5. Next page. Now we are going to start the letter R. Start it first from the first dotted line. Start from the dotted line, children. Write neatly as it is over the dotted line. It should be inside the blue line only. It should not come out from the blue line. So the pattern of the handwriting is very, very important. Sharp your pencil, rotate your pencil and make use of the sharp edge of your pencils to write the dotted line, then only it will, you can write it over the dotted lines, children. Write neatly. So that's all. I have completed the dotted line. Now I'm going to write the next line. Follow the same thing. So first you should start with this. So this is the way you need to write, children. Slantingly you should write. Follow the same pattern as it is. The curve should be as it is to be written. So follow the same format, children. So that's all. I have completed dotted line as well as the first line. Next line you need to write. So in today's handwriting part, we have completed page number 5, letter M, and page number 6, letter R. This both should be completed, page 5 and 6. So follow the same lines as it is. Don't write extra lines as your wish. Whatever you write, it should be neat. As per the stroke, it is given in the dotted line. First, don't forget to write the date. Please write the date, sharp your pencil and then write. Draw lines like this. Then only your handwriting book will be neat. When we see and when we correct, so it should be neat. So follow the format and follow the handwriting pattern as it is. So write neatly and send your works. Send your handwriting photocopies through Teachmint and your reading video in the group. So children, follow the instruction and do your work properly and send your assignments regularly.